Running down to Cuba with a load of sugar.
Hey! Way, me boys, to Cuba.
Make a run, you lime juice squeezers.
Running down to Cuba.
Cuba is one of the most beautiful yet isolated places in the world.
Cuba was founded by Christopher Columbus. Baracoa, the first colony, was founded by Diego Velázquez de Sella.
Christopher Columbus is known for his discovery of the Americas, but most people don't realize his first major discovery, although it is in the Americas, the West Indies.
Columbus was a major jerk, but like most major jerks, he did have ambition. He set out to find an overseas route to India. Like most major jerks, he ended up messing up. And finding himself in the Americas, the place where he landed was then known as the West Indies, now as the Caribbean.
One of the areas he discovered in the West Indies is now known as Cuba, a mortal enemy of the United States.
You can see how some of his major jerkness rubbed off.
What do you have against the Columbus?
Well, after bartering with the King of Spain to become the governor of the Spanish colonies, he tortured the native population, sold criminals and his political enemies into slavery, and gave cruel and unusual punishments, among other acts of tyranny. He once punished a man found guilty of stealing corn by cutting off his ears and nails and selling him into slavery.
That is rough.
There's more.
I think that's enough, Chansol. Anyway, the first colony of Cuba was Baracoa, founded in 1511. Then there was Santiago de Cuba in 1514, and finally Havana in 1515. It's a common misconception that Havana was the first colony of Cuba, as it is now the capital.
But because they brought a bunch of diseases with them to Cuba and wiped out the native population in under 10 years.
By the 1760s, Cuba began to flourish. Its main income came from its main exports of curd rice and tobacco, and later sugar. It became apparent that more labor was required, but there weren't enough laborers. So, like in New England, the Spanish began to import African slaves to Cuba.
However, there were other major powers in the New World. One of these was New England.
The problem was, Spain possessed the trade monopoly in the Caribbean, which they intended to keep. They did this by preventing the Spanish colonies from trading with foreign ships.
During the Seven Years' War, New England defeated New France and also annexed Cuba because they wanted it for its good trading centers.
Cuba was annexed even though its defenses were raised because of pirate attacks. However, it didn't last long.
British sugar merchants feared a decline in sales and forced the British government to sign a treaty with Spain, which gave Florida to the British colonies.
However, because of constant turmoil and Spain's policies, Cuba's economic growth was stunted. When Spain reopened Cuba's ports, a sugar boom that lasted until the 1880s happened. But this peace was not to last.
The success of the Declaration of Independence, the American Revolution, the French Revolution, and the removal of King Ferdinand VII stirred up whispers of revolution.
Finally, in 1878, Cubans launched the 10 Years' War, which is pretty much a revolution against the Spanish government in Cuba, and in 1886, this abolished slavery.
And with the support of the U.S. government, Cuban writer and patriot Jose Marti led another revolution against Spain, which sparked the Spanish-American War and led to the Independent Republic of Cuba being established in 1899. Until Tomas Estrada Palma was elected president in 1902, the U.S. had a continued presence in Cuba.
After 400 years of colonization, the Cubans had finally gained their independence.